Everybody loves a good love story. Now throw in a couple of vampires and you've got box office gold. Well, at least that's what this cast is hoping for with their new movie, Twilight.
What's up, MTV Canada? I'm Rochelle Lefebvre, and you're on set exclusively with Twilight.
We're rolling. Quiet all around, please.
Twilight is based on a young adult novel. It's massively popular.
There's a trilogy, and this is the first in the trilogy.
It's a story about a 17-year-old girl who moves to a new town and meets this family of strange-looking people, and one of which she thinks hates her initially, but has this kind of weird, almost palpable connection with, and then she finds out he's actually a vampire who wants to kill her all the time, and then they fall in love.
And it's sort of a star-crossed love story between Bella and Edward.
I can't believe you're making me do this.
Just smile.
Well, it's too late.
And it's like a struggle to keep it, because there's just no living with an immortal. Like, if everybody wants to kill you and he doesn't want to make you an immortal, it's like a Romeo and Juliet type situation.
And so it's also sort of an action adventure between the two of them that involves them getting into a little bit of trouble. Well, I play as Victoria, and I play a nomadic vampire. In Stephanie's world, there are more peaceful vampires, and then there are the vampires you don't want to meet in the street. My character is one of those vampires you don't want to meet in the street. I am the female badass. There is very much a male badass. Cam Gigande plays James, and he's phenomenal. And I play his mate and partner in crime, if you'll forgive the cliched expression.
The adaptation really shocked. I mean, it was really shocking when I first read the script, because I mean, it was so much faster paced. It's like reads kind of like an action script. So I mean, that really shocked me.
We haven't strayed from the story. I mean, it's like we had to consolidate an entire novel. So there were things that we couldn't do every single scene, situation in the book.
Trilogy and stuff. I mean, I hope I've just kind of made it, put enough into the performance to make it interesting enough to, you know. Just a play, I guess, for another two movies. I mean, there's a lot of material there, and there's a lot of, you know, interesting ways to go with it. I mean, the books definitely work. I mean, I wanted to read the second two after reading the first one.
So in the beginning, we were all sort of learning the sort of vampire world and putting it on, and we all learned how to wear our contact lenses together, you know, and, bitching about it hurts and all that stuff, and then learning how to do the movement, and we had some stunt work, and so we all just kind of got thrown into a vampire camp together and just bonded. Actually, I got to do wire work, which was incredible. You literally, like, get to, you know, like flying through the air at 30 feet up. It's madness. And we had to do this thing called the magic carpet, which is really hard to explain, except try and imagine yourself walking on a platform that's being pulled along the ground at 30 miles an hour. So yeah, I totally had a good time handling that.
The actual sexuality in it is, you know, it's kind of harder to understand. I mean, it's like, it's not just, they're just innocent. It doesn't even cross their minds. I mean, the entire time it's like desperately wanting to, but I mean, it's impossible. I mean, it's not like they're really young kids. It's like they're like 18, and so it's sort of, yeah, well, what are you doing? I mean, I think it's a lot more complex than just your average teenage thing, because I mean, they stick with each other even though they can't have a normal relationship. They can't like go to house parties and stuff. It's like they live in this tiny little town and they're just living for each other.
Whatever you can't have, you're just going to want it 10 times more. So if they're not shoving sex down your throat and they're making you like think about it yourself, it's a little bit more of like an elaborate, it's just more juicy, it's just better. So yeah, I hope people like that.
I actually think that younger audiences are going to love it. I mean, if you think about what Baz Luhrmann did with Romeo and Juliet, I mean, they had a single love scene basically in that, and all you really see them do is kiss. And when I saw that, you know, movie, and people who were even younger than me were responding to that with this like incredible, like, oh my God, and they were swooning in their seats.
The thing with vampires, I mean, I guess what they've morphed into is just being, they're like a god, but not really at all. I mean, it's like a curse and a blessing at the same time. So it's like kind of all powerful, but they're totally helpless. I guess that's what the attraction is, I think.
It's a big deal for people. I mean, for me, I think the most interesting about it is just like the questions that it brings up about life. I mean, like, that's all you're questioning in the world anyway, but it raises different concerns. It's like, live life to the fullest.
It's pretty mind-boggling. Like, we knew it had a built-in audience. We just didn't know how much excitement there would be about the movie so early on. I got recognized in a cafe the other day. I had the girl behind the counter and was like, can I, and this wasn't in Portland, it was in Los Angeles. She was like, can I ask you a question? Are you playing Victoria on Twilight? And I'm like, you've got to be kidding me. Like, I haven't even finished filming yet. So yeah, it's mind-boggling.